Good afternoon, students. Today we are on flywheels. I'll try to sum up this topic and then we'll do a practical example on the other side. On flywheels, I think these are the important aspects we have to look upon. We have I as representing the momentum of the inertia. We have M represent the mass, K the radius of the is the radius of the radiation. Then we have got beta, the angular acceleration. We've got A is the linear acceleration. S represent the displacement. N represent the radius in minutes. Then, once you master all this, you'll be able to deal with problems related to flywheels. Okay, right. These are the formulas that you are supposed to master in order for you to be able to work out some problems on flywheels. We have the angular acceleration, which represents as W2. The angular acceleration is equal to W1 plus beta minus by t, multiplied by t, which is time. Then we have the angle, which is theta. Theta is represented by half times beta times time squared plus W multiplied by t. Then we have the linear velocity, which is V, which is equals to WT multiplied by R. This is the radius, by the way. Then the tangential velocity, which is equals to V, which is V, is equals to, this is not allowed, this is not allowed, this is not allowed, this is not allowed, this is not allowed. Which is equals to U is equals to A multiplied by T. Then we've got the contrapetal acceleration, which is equals to V squared divided by R or W multiplied by R. Okay, right. Now, let's look at an example. The example says, if a flywheel is uniform, is at uniform acceleration from 12 rev per second in 8.5 seconds. It's my marker. Can I change this marker and use this one? A flywheel is uniformly accelerated from rest. We have to master the word that rest, because if it's at rest, meaning there is an initial acceleration of zero. Okay, right. It's 12 rev per second in 8.5 seconds. Alright, the diameter of the wheel is 1.6 meter. We are given that the diameter is 1.6 meter divided by 2. Okay, we'll convert it later, by the way, because it's not a matter of dividing by 2. We have to convert meters into centimeters, then we'll divide this by 2 so that we can get it in millimeters. Alright, then the question says, calculate the angular acceleration of the flywheel. Angular acceleration is given by W2, which is equals to, this this acceleration, the initial one with the angular multiplied by time. Then we are given this 12. Then from there we know that it is 2 pi multiplied by 12. Then from here, because we say it is at rest, meaning the initial velocity is 0 plus the angular which we are looking for, then time we are given that it is 8.5 seconds. Then from there you transpose. When you transpose, you will have this angular velocity is 2 pi multiplied by 12. Then you bring it this side, you add with 8.5, where you will get 8.87 rand. It's a radiant per second squared. That's how we calculate the angular velocity. Then number B, you are required to calculate the angle, the actual angle. The actual angle given by theta, you say theta is equal to half beta multiplied by time squared plus the initial velocity multiplied by time. Then we substitute. It's half multiply, we have this here, it's 8.87. Then we have time, we are given time as 8.5 seconds. Remember, squared plus this velocity, which is the initial velocity. We say that it's at rest, meaning this is 0, then multiplied by time, which is 8.5 seconds. Then here, when you press your calculator here, you will find that the angle is 3.204 radians. It's measured in radians. That's the angle we are looking for. Then from there, they are required to find the linear velocity. We say that the linear velocity is equal to, let me say VL as the linear velocity. We say that the linear velocity is equal to W2R. And remember, we have this, and then we have to find the radius. The radius, we are not given the radius, we are given the diameter. The only thing we have to do here, we have to convert this into centimeters. But now, let's just not convert it, let's just deal with it as it's in meters. We only divide by 2, then here you will find that this is 0.8. meters, which is our radius. Then let's come and substitute here. We have this as 2 pi times 12, but we did manage to find this value here. Okay, let's use 2 pi. It's 2 pi multiplied by 12, then multiplied by r, 0.8. Our radius is 0.8. Then The pressure calculator is 2 pi times 12 times 0.8. Then the velocity, linear velocity, will be equal to 60.32 meters per second. Because we didn't convert the radius into millimeters. That's why our unit says it's meters per second, which are the standard units. All right, let's proceed. We find number D. Number D, we are looking at the tangential velocity, which is equal to, let me say, V, so that you can clearly see, because we have a different type of velocities here. Let me say VT. VT is equal to our U plus A, our U plus AT. Then this is the same as initial velocity, which we are told that this is at rest, which means here you will put 0 plus A. This acceleration, we are given that it's 8.5. No, pardon, this is our time, by the way. 8.5 is our time. Then we are given that we were able to calculate this is the velocity we are looking for, by the way, our A. This is the velocity we are looking for. Then we are given time, that time is 8.5 here. Let me do like this. We did manage to get the velocity here. We are using this velocity as 60.32. Then from there, we transpose. Then we'll have A. We transpose this to the other side. Then we multiply this with 8.5, where we find that our velocity A is equal to 7.096 meters per second squared. Then lastly, we have to find the contrapetal acceleration. The contrapetal acceleration is given that by, let me say, it's acceleration C, so that you can clearly understand the contrapetal acceleration. It is not written like this, just for the matter of understanding in my specimen is not enough. I will write contrapetal acceleration, but instead of writing that, I'm writing this AC. Alright. Let's say the formula says it's V squared divided by R, our radius. We have this velocity, which is equal to 60.32 squared divided by our radius, it's 0.8 meters. Then when you press your calculator, it's 60.32 squared all over 0.8. You find that the answer is, it's 4.548 meter per second squared. Yes. As for today, we'll end here. What I want to emphasize are the units, because you might calculate and find all the relevant answers that are correct, but if you didn't put the units in all of your answers, you will find that you miss some marks or you get it wrong. And another thing, remember to round off your answer into three or two decimal places. Our lessons for today will end here. Thank you.